U.S. is ranked 41st in math, 24th in science, 24th in reading, and 25th in science. That's not very good. Sidney J. Harris said, the whole purpose of education is to turn mirrors into windows. That pretty much means that the whole purpose of education is to not look back at our mistakes and not keep U.S. education the way it is. We have to learn from our mistakes and we have to find ways to make U.S. education better. We think that there are certain methods to help improve American education. Multi-age classrooms, less but improved homework, and longer school days are needed to improve American education. We think that it will really help American education, so we better get to work and turn that mirror into a window.
What is multi-age classroom? Multi-age is a way students can cooperate with one another to solve a problem and develop strong social skills. They can learn many ways and strategies of learning and even find a strength within the help of others. Some kids tend to work alone and work without a partner, and because of that, they might never know a way to solve something they are not good at. Different people are good at different things. What multi-age does, it makes you experimental, and it helps your failures. Multi-age provides all this good stuff which can improve our education. The first advantage, it contains different ages in one classroom, which provides social skills. This first disadvantage, bullying rarely happens, but parents think it does, so they end up not sending little kids to school to multi-age classroom. And the second advantage, students with same teachers are benefiting more because they are used to the techniques, consequences, and solutions and aware of them. This is what multi-age provides.
Homework gets tougher and tougher for each grade, as you can see in the comic. In addition to this, there's a lot. Katie Elliott states this in an article she wrote 6 years ago as a senior in high school. I think that for most teachers, we should have less and improved homework. Some improvements would be like applying the five hallmarks, which are ownership, competence, efficiency, purpose, and make sure it doesn't look too crowded. And homework also shouldn't be repetition, and it shouldn't include non-academic skills like cutting and gluing paper. Basically, this is a part of efficiency. Also, ownership is how to motivate kids to do the thing they need to do. And I don't think we have a lot of this in schools in the U.S. What is happening now with homework? Homework is becoming a chore, says a mother in California. The comment on the slide says that the ones that used to read are now choosing the easiest book and stopping when the timer dings. There are positives and negatives about having homework. The negatives are that homework increases and it's way too much in high school. And it gives a lot less time for extracurricular activities like playing tennis. The positives of homework are that it helps kids learn what they need to know, not writing it over and over again, which is a rote memory task. And it makes sure that the kids have paid attention in the classroom, and it will allow friends to get together in study groups, and also it reinforces the concepts that were learned at school.
69% of teachers say that they don't have enough instructional time, so longer school days are needed to improve American education. Educators are extending some schools 30 minutes or even 2 hours. The popularity of longer school day got a major boost in 2013. There are some advantages and disadvantages. One advantage is that there's extra time for specials and enrichment activities, like phys ed, which is gym, and music. There's also more time to focus on kids' trouble areas. And there's more time for teachers to work in groups with their students. A disadvantage is that more time doesn't mean more learning. So even if the teacher is teaching, the students might not be paying attention. so they wouldn't learn anything. There's also less time for outdoor activities or sports after school. Rebecca Cusick, a fourth grade teacher and president of Fall Rivers Educators Association, says, "We've seen schools that have added as many as 90 minutes to their day improve quite dramatically. So longer school days are improving American education."
We did a survey, and one of the questions we asked were, do you think multi-age classrooms would benefit learning? Well, as you can see, 14 said no, and 6 said yes. I wonder why. Well, I think the 6 that said yes were kids, and they thought they could work in groups together to improve their skills. And I think the 14 no's were parents thinking that multi-age classrooms could cause bullying. Did you know, for fun fact, that studies show that multi-age classroom actually decreases bullying?
Another one of the questions that we had in our survey was, do you like the idea of longer school days with less homework? We think that the bar is higher on yes, because you can focus on learn more on strategies you're familiar with.
Another question we asked in our survey was, can homework benefit learning? Well, 20 out of 20 thought homework can benefit. Why? Well, think about it. When teachers skip homework, it's usually a review of what they did in class. And that's just refreshing their memories. So we think that 20 out of 20 think homework can benefit.
In this analysis, we found out that everyone agreed that homework benefits learning 100%. 70% disliked multi-age, 30% liked multi-age, 75% liked longer school days, 20% disliked, and 5% said neither.
The roots of education and the fruit is sweet, according to Aristotle. All the hard work we do adds up to a sweet life. But what if the education isn't good enough to add up to one, no matter what we do? This is how it feels like in U.S. schools. Education in the U.S. is falling behind, and we need to catch up. If we want to help educate children properly, we need to use these methods. We need to educate the next generation in the U.S. and use these new ideas, because so far our methods aren't working as well as the students, along with the teacher, want them to. Don't think what I should do to help myself with my child with education, but what I should do to help my country with education. We have to help the U.S. fight in the fight for education, so make that life sweet.
These are the sources we use for multi-age classroom, homework overload, and the longer school day slides. And these are the art credits, which are the graphics and pictures in our slides.
Any
question from
you? I have one, and this is to you, and actually it's I saved it because I wanted to almost ask this to everyone, but the PISA scores. Certainly, you know, we are at a place where we don't want to be as an American school, but I guess I would also take a look. I want you to take, when you look at international testing and scores like that, to take a look and see if we are comparing apples to apples, meaning, like, how many students in the United States are going to the schools and being tested in this? And then and also in other countries, are they similar statistics? So when we're comparing internationally, that's important to know. Even in the United States, if, you know, we look at our ACT scores, they might drop over time, but part of that was because we have more and more students that are taking it, where in the past it might have been just like the top students take it, and now it's more. So I would just encourage you to look at your research there. Certainly we have room and we want to continue to grow, but just take a look at that research a little bit and see if we're always comparing exactly the same.
Well, we found out that China only sent their top students to take the test, so it might not be comparing apples to apples, maybe apples.
Yeah, and another interesting piece, we lead the world in innovative patents, and our universities, you know, produce more innovators than any other country on the planet. So interesting things that we can talk about.
Glad you brought that up. glad you searched that out, though, that you looked at that. And when you're looking at your research, it's always good to look at the details of how those statistics come out.
And they did read some articles on that as well. Good. And they also looked at, what was it we found about our colleges? Do you all remember that? It was been weeks ago.
Yeah.
The group up here, does someone want to share what you found?
The colleges were doing really well, so like they were in like the top, like somewhere in the hundreds and tens. And, but like the PISA scores were going down, even though the colleges were really high.
And where did people want to go to college?
In the U.S.
And we were dominating the top ones, right?
Yeah, but I think it's because in 21st century, people are not focusing on much on school. They're more focusing on sports and extracurricular activities. So those colleges were invented a few decades ago. So I think it has something to do with the 21st century.
Other questions?
I had one about the if we extend our school day 2 hours, like if we did that extreme, do we need to serve dinner? I just want to check and see, because I love dinner, but I've never had school day before. It would affect like probably lunches and things.
We do have time for one more question, Mrs. Culbertson.
It was interesting to me, a comment that was a disadvantage on the multi-age classroom that it benefited only the younger students, with a discussion that was in the group before on how learning is reinforced by teaching. So do you think maybe there would also be an advantage to the older students if they were able to work with their younger classmates and teach what they've learned or helped out, and it reinforces it for both parties?
They benefit more because they see different ways, and the little kids, they learn different ways of learning. They can, the bigger kids, when they're helping the little kids and see their strategies, they can improve by using the little kids' strategies and making their own strategy, or using the little kids' strategy and sharing it with the class, helping all the classmates to become better.
So it is advantageous for both ages.
Yeah, because in multi-age classrooms, older kids do help younger kids.
Right.
Like, parents might think that older kids might bully, but actually, I guess that they're taught older students usually help the younger kids, like, learn if they don't understand something.
And usually the older students develop good leadership skills.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. In fact, we used to have multi-age looping classrooms. So the teachers stay with the kids. We used to have that about in my elementary experience. That's what I had amazing.
And my child did. My child did.
And
amazing.
My daughter as well.
They do. Yeah. So you guys have